The plains of Arafah, serene and vast, a sea of white stretching towards the horizon. Join me as we explore the profound significance of the Day of Arafah, a day where millions of believers gather, united in their faith, seeking forgiveness and closeness to the Almighty. Our journey begins with a historical understanding of this sacred day. Imagine the scorching Arabian sun beating down on the plains of Arafah. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, stands before a multitude of his followers. It is here, on this day, that the final verses of the Holy Quran were revealed, marking the completion of God's divine message to humanity. These verses, etched in the heart of the Quran, resonate with a timeless message of unity, submission, and unwavering belief in the oneness of God. The Day of Arafah, forever entwined with this momentous occasion, becomes a symbol of spiritual completion and the boundless mercy of the Almighty. It's a day where the past, present, and future converge. The Day of Arafah is a day of intense spiritual reflection and physical cleansing, often observed with a voluntary fast. This act of self-restraint transcends the physical realm, becoming a testament to one's commitment to spiritual growth and purification. Fasting, in its essence, is an act of surrendering to a higher purpose, a means of drawing closer to the divine. The Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said that fasting on the day of Arafah expiates the sins of the past year and the coming year. Imagine the weight of your transgressions, the burdens you carry, lifted from your shoulders. This promise of forgiveness, however, is not a license to sin freely. Instead, it's a call to introspection, to examine our actions and strive for continuous improvement. As we abstain from food and drink, we are reminded of the true sustenance that comes from seeking God's forgiveness and mercy. The physical hunger we experience pales in comparison to the spiritual nourishment we receive through prayer, repentance, and reflection. It's an opportunity to cleanse our hearts, purify our intentions, and emerge from this sacred day renewed and spiritually rejuvenated. As the sun rises over Arafah, millions lift their hands, their voices filled with the sacred words of Dua, a prayer of deep beauty and meaning. It's a moment of true vulnerability where hearts open up to the Creator and every word reflects a year's worth of hopes, dreams, fears, and regrets. The Dua of Arafah is more than just words. It's a sincere conversation with the Divine. It's a way to show gratitude for blessings, ask for forgiveness, and seek guidance and mercy. The verses recognize our human limits and our need for the Almighty. We pray for the sick, the suffering, and the oppressed, for peace in a conflicted world, and for guidance for those who have lost their way. As we pray together, we connect to a shared spirit that goes beyond language, culture, and borders. In that shared devotion, we see the power of unity, the strength of standing together as one Ummah, united by our faith and humanity. Imagine standing amongst millions, a sea of humanity united in their devotion. The air vibrates with a powerful energy as voices rise in unison, reciting the sacred words of Talil, Takbir, Tahmid, and Tasbih. These repetitive phrases, simple yet profound, form the heartbeat of remembrance, the lifeblood of spiritual connection. Tahlil, the declaration of La ilaha illallah. There is no God but Allah, serves as a constant reminder of the oneness of God, a reaffirmation of our faith and a rejection of all false idols. Takbir, the exclamation of Allahu Akbar, God is the greatest, is an acknowledgement of God's absolute power. his dominion over all creation. Tamid, the glorification of God through Alhamdulillah, praise be to God, is an expression of gratitude for the countless blessings bestowed upon us. Tasbih, the declaration of Subhanallah, glory be to God, is an affirmation of God's absolute perfection, his transcendence above all flaws and imperfections. These recitations, repeated throughout the day of Arafah, are not merely empty rituals. They are a means of purifying the heart, of aligning our thoughts, words, and actions with the divine will. This spiritual practice transcends the physical realm, elevating our souls and drawing us closer to the source of all peace, love, and forgiveness. The day of Arafah is a day for seeking forgiveness, a day to shed the weight of our transgressions and experience the profound liberation that comes with divine absolution. Imagine the weight of your past mistakes, the regrets, the guilt, and the shame lifted from your shoulders. As we stand before God, acknowledging our imperfections and pleading for His mercy, a profound transformation takes place within our hearts. The walls we have built around ourselves crumble, replaced by a sense of vulnerability and a deep longing for redemption. It's not just about seeking forgiveness for individual transgressions, but also about cultivating a spirit of forgiveness towards others. Just as we hope for God's mercy, we are called upon to extend that same mercy to those who have wronged us. This act of forgiveness, of releasing the anger, resentment, and bitterness that can poison our hearts, is a testament to our own capacity for compassion and understanding. Seeking forgiveness on the day of Arafah is not a passive act. It requires sincere remorse for our actions, a firm commitment to change, and a genuine desire to mend our ways. But the beauty of God's mercy is that it knows no bounds. No matter how far we have strayed, no matter the magnitude of our transgressions, the door to repentance and forgiveness is always open. As we stand on the plains of Arafah, surrounded by millions who share our desire for redemption, we are reminded that we are not alone in our struggles. As the sun sets on the day of Arafah, millions of faithful hearts feel lighter, sins forgiven, and spirits renewed. The journey of Arafah, however, does not end with the setting sun. As we carry the lessons of Arafah within our hearts, may we strive to embody the spirit of this sacred day in our thoughts, our words, and our deeds.